Martin, there is a direct threat to all 50 state capitals. That's what the FBI is saying. I'm curious, do they have the security resources to respond, right? Are you seeing it there?
Right. Well, those are two different questions. So first, do they have the resources? Governor Brian Kemp, who of course has had a falling out with the president, says that they do have the resources. They are ready. Although he also says that he perceives that the threat is low against the state of Georgia and against the Capitol here, which is an interesting statement given the fact that Georgia's played such a pivotal role in two critical elections, voting for Joe Biden and then, of course, the overturning and making the Senate Democratic. Here's security measures that are being worked on right now. These are not a reaction as to what happened in Washington. This is more of a long-term security issue that they've been working on. It's going to be a permanent fence, and as you can tell, it's definitely not going to be in place by this weekend or in any time for the inauguration. Let me point out, they have this. This is the kind of security fencing you may have seen around the Capitol on the day of the protest. It's pretty flimsy stuff. Any dedicated crowd could easily punch through. Now, they have beefed up the security presence here. In fact, you can see you've got an armored vehicle like this one right here. This is belonging to the Georgia State Patrol. So you've got the quasi-military stance of the Georgia State Patrol. You've got Atlanta police that are standing by, any number of federal forces that can respond as well to the Capitol. So they believe that on top of the National Guard, I should point out, they've got several dozen National Guard troops positioned or ready to move in here. But they're also sending 300 National Guard troops to the U.S. Capitol. So Georgia says it's ready. I guess they'll find out maybe as soon as this weekend.